Hello and good evening. It's Wednesday at 12:21 a.m. and I'm here in my kitchen and I have Tuxi here. Hi, say hi. And I'm going to be making banana bread. And I have to pull up the recipe. Where is it? There it is, okay. Preheat oven to 350 degrees. Meow. And I am sluggish right now because I ate almost a whole box of Triscuits with artichoke bruschetta that I like. And I just kept eating and munching and munching. And I don't want to even cook right now. I just want to curl up in bed, but I have to use my bananas because they need it. All right, mix white sugar, brown sugar, and melted butter. Melt the butter. Oh no, that's for pumpkin bread. I'm not making pumpkin bread. Banana bread recipe? 350, half a cup of butter softened. Half a cup. So, this is a quarter cup, and these little butter sticks are so cute. I keep trying to be like fasting and eating clean, but then I get hungry and it's really hard to fight it. 1 cup of sugar. Oh, my sugar got wet on my last cooking adventure. I don't know what's going on in there. Oh, jeez. All right, I'm going to use this amount of sugar, 2/3 of a cup, and then I'm going to add some honey, or should I use brown sugar? Have my brown sugar out. Yeah. All right. Let's just play around in Amanda's kitchen this evening. I wish my gym was still open. I could go sit in the sauna, but it's not. And I went for a walk earlier, but it wasn't enough. I found this guy, Mark Berrier or something, and he's like this amazing musician, and he's funny too, quite the artist, and I was watching his videos all day, just with a huge smile on my face. I know I'm butchering his last name, it's something French, I believe. And I was sending links to my friends, and they were like cracking up all day, watching and rewatching this video. These people dancing around in their apartment and stuff. Cream together butter and sugar. 2 eggs beaten. Let's get all the bowls that I possibly can dirty. fork. And my honey cake turned out really great. I know I didn't have cinnamon, but I used some ginger and some cloves. And it was totally fine. I wouldn't even know the difference. And it's all gone. And I probably should have cut the sugar in the recipe. I usually do, but I just totally forgot, probably because I was filming. My friend who lives in Colombia made me one time when I was down in Panama, and it was such good banana bread, but it calls for buttermilk, and I've never made buttermilk. I know you can make it with like cream and some sort of acid, but I don't want to risk that. Right in there. Oh, sure, it's fine. Totally fine. Let me see what I'm doing here. Right. Add the eggs and the bananas. So, one egg in there. And for banana bread, what I've researched, it says to use them ripe, and when they're brown is when they're really great, because the more mushy they get, the more flavorful they are, and for texture purposes. And these are not really old, like these are just as old as these ones, but I took these on a walk with me the other day, and they got kind of a little bit bruised in my satchel. That's why they look like this. But they're gonna be great. I've made banana bread before. And I'm going to use, it calls for three, but I like to use four, but I'm gonna save one for breakfast tomorrow. Am I? Yeah, I'll save that. Nature is weird. This one? Yeah, this one needs to go in there. And I thought I had bought some banana extract to make it like really, really banana flavor, but I can't find it. And I crawled up in there, looked around. Maybe I dreamt that I bought it. I used it already. It's okay if it's still chunky, because then when you eat it, you get banana chunks in your mouth, and it's great. Yeah, 4 would have been too much, I feel like. Combine well. Sift together flour, soda, and salt. Baking soda, you mean? Baking soda. Stuck. One teaspoon of baking soda. And I like to add the baking soda or baking powder to the wet ingredients. That way the moisture can like sort of get the chemical reactions going. I feel like that might happen better when you do it this way. Salt, half a teaspoon of salt. I used to have an actual flour sifter where you'd put it in the thing and you'd go like this and it would fall out of the bottom and be real fluffy, but I think if I just dump my flour in here and sort of like sift it, that'll be great. One and a half cups of flour. Do it one at a time. Oh yeah, I forgot to add the vanilla in there. And I use way more vanilla than any recipe ever calls for because it's delicious, and when you cook it, you can't, excuse me, really taste it. Oh, it smells like alcohol. I used to drink stuff like this at clubs and stuff, and. Never again. Half a teaspoon of vanilla. We're just gonna dump that right in there like that. Ooh, the smell took me back. Oh, I can still smell it. Oh my gosh. Half a cup of flour extra. Does it say to grease and flour? Yes, it does. So I will grease and flour my loaf pan. And another reason why I didn't use my friend's recipe is because it calls for to make two loaves. And I could have made one and then frozen one, but I don't really like to eat frozen stuff. It's just not as good as fresh. Some nuts to use. I have some hazelnuts and some chopped walnuts that I should probably use up. Questionable not doing it. These I just got recently. Those have been in my pantry a while, we'll just say. Yes, these are beautiful and not dusty. Good amount too. Sweet. Ooh, I could have even put some lemon rind in there, which I had planned on it. Should I do it? No, I'm not going to do that. Baking soda in the fridge. Grease and flour the pan. Okay, I'll do that. Excuse me, I'm full of Triscuits and I'm burping and I'm sorry. Butter. I have some butter here. Oh, I just put the flour away. Okay. nice and buttery, and then that will melt into the bread, I think. Oh, so much butter on my hands. Flour. I wonder if you could use powdered sugar instead of flour to flour a pan, but I'm not going to try it right now. Some other day, when I make two loaves at once, I'll try that and I'll test that theory. I also know how to make this blueberry lemon loaf, and it's really good. And then when it's done, you make like a lemon sauce frosting, and you pour it all over it, and it soaks in, and it's really good. Sort of like the honey cake I made, but with blueberries instead of, yeah, pretty similar actually. All right. I have my stuff here ready to go into the oven almost. And I need a spatula. Beautiful in the pan. And I have to go to the store tomorrow and get some strawberries because I love strawberries with my banana loaves. And I love banana loaves with my coffee, but I'm trying to quit the coffee and move towards a hot lemon water in the morning type thing with some ginger or turmeric and cayenne. I was doing that for a while, but I stopped. All right, so batter in here. Oh gosh. Center. Whenever I do that, it's so hot, the heat comes out, and then it, like, glues my eyelashes together, and they can get all sticky. And, oh, I should time it. So, 350 for 55 minutes. It is 12:47, so I need a calculator. I'm not even mad. Oh, gosh. 13 minutes will make it. I don't know how to do it on a calculator. This is so embarrassing. Okay, no one needs to know how bad you are at math, Amanda. Hey, I have a college degree, okay? I can do math. Alright, 13 minutes plus 42 minutes? Is that 55? Okay, so at 1:42, no. Yeah, at 1:42 a.m., my bread should be done, but maybe I'll come check it a little bit before because I don't want it overcooked. I did that without a calculator. Aren't you proud? Oh, hi! Oh my gosh! She's on a diet! Say hi to the world. Hi! She's on a diet. She doesn't like it. She doesn't like it. She doesn't like the diet. I love you. Oh, so cute. Okay, and I'm going to clean this up. What am I gonna do next? I'm so full of Triscuits. Like, I ate. Why did I just do that? I ate so many. And now I'm full. And it's dark out, so I can't go walk it off. Should probably do some living room exercises or something. Try the Tai Chi DVD I've had for months. Me wash some dishes. I really don't like dishes, but they have to be done. I've been good about them. I don't like to go to sleep with dishes in my sink. I think I've been getting better about it. Flour paste all in the sink from the stuff. I need a dishwasher that works. Thank you. Just throw it in there. So it's nice and shiny. Look, I put my dish soap in a dial thing, and that way I can just squirt out one squirt per dish, because I like to squirt a lot of stuff out because it's really fun and gets really sudsy, but then I don't have any dish soap because I used half a bottle to wash my dishes. So I improvised and evolved. Yay! Everything's beautiful. But then I got tired. The light is so bright, it just makes me tired for some reason. Use this hair tie for my brown sugar. I'm covered in cat hair, can you see? No, you actually can't see it. I've been picking Tuxie up all day. She loves it, of course. No, that doesn't go in the fridge, does it? No. This goes in the fridge. And probably let that sit there for ambiance. This gigantic jar of hominy, and I don't know what to do with it. I found some recipes on Pinterest for like creamed hominy with peppers, and it sounds really good, but the cream, I'm trying to get away from dairy, but at the same time it would probably be incredible. Maybe I could like cut it in half or something and just use half the recipe. And I've washed my paintbrushes. So they're ready for my next adventure. And I guess I'll go in my room now. And I'm on my QuickTime instead of going live because something kept kicking me off of my lives. And it was frustrating. And some of them came back, but then they deleted some other ones. And right here, I should probably set my phone timer for my... For my bread here, 42 minutes. And if I were to do one thing for my paintings, what would it be? I'm not really in the mood, but I should probably do it. Before I get too tired, even though I've been up till like 4 and 5 in the morning the last few nights, so I know I'll be up for a while. So try to make some progress. And I had my first online class today at UNLV, and it was pretty awkward, but it was also really fun, and it was really good to see my fellow students, and my professor's tiny little face. And the internet connection wasn't the greatest, and I have a hard time hearing her anyway. So I'm sure she didn't miss that. Me asking her to repeat herself. What? You're beautiful. Aw, her and I match. Look. Why are you so cute? She's lost weight already in her neck. It's not as fat as it was. I think the fat was like choking her windpipe or something. Hi. Smack your butt. Smack your butt. What are you gonna do about it? What are you gonna do about it? She loves it. Okay. So, I mentioned in a video that I wanted to remove some of this dark stuff and to bring out more of the yellow. And this is gouache. So, what I have learned from gouache is that you can, in fact, you can remove your paint to an extent. Usually it will stain the paper, but then you can paint over it. Excuse me. And that's fine if I still have a stain here. Hi. I love you too. And then I won't be able to paint the yellow today because if you try to paint on a section that's already damp, you're probably going to end up taking more paint off than you put on, kind of. It's kind of tricky, but I got the hang of it. And so I'll probably just remove what I want to remove and then let it dry overnight so it's like bone dry, And then I'll go over it with the yellow because it's so pretty. It's like a nice lemon yellow, real bright. And I used one calligraphy brush for this painting, so I will keep with that. Actually, no, I used. A different brush to lift the color off. So I think I'll be okay. Pour some of my water in here. And then I'll just go through. And I'll probably. I think there's some like, see how, oh no, you can't see. There's some branches here and here. But I think there's some on this side that I didn't do, and I wonder if I should put them in for like balance. I say like an umala, I'm sorry. I don't mean to. So I noticed that I turn on my overhead light? Probably, but I don't like it. It stresses me out. What I would like to do is bring this down. Have a towel here? I should get a towel. And you see how it just comes up pretty easily here? I'm gonna have to lift. I'm lifting, but I'm also still trying to shape the green, how it'll come down there. I just want it to be. Different shape than what it is. So your eye will be guided in a certain way. And then there's some yellow here that I can add, and then the yellow comes down. I like that. I'm not going to change that. You see how easily it comes up, even though it's pretty dark. Because I like this light patch right here, and this dark area, it is beautiful. I do love it, because my yard didn't get a lot of sun. So the shadows were nice as well as the sun coming through, so it's not like I want to just not have that in there. And we had fireflies, And I would catch them in my dad's empty beer mug. I know that sounds real classy, but that's what it was in the summer. A bit of this. Trying to lift and then also think of the shape and also, excuse me, think of the leaf shapes. I wonder if I could lift stuff from this section. Don't know. I already tried. But if I can get it lighter, that'd be great. But also, if it stays fuzzy, then it kind of looks like light coming through. So that's pretty cool. these little light spots. And I'm trying to create those. And it's working, so it's great. I like this whole section here. Look at Duxie. What are you doing? What are you doing? Pit, pit, pit. I'm gonna make it so much more yellow. It's gonna be great. Thank you.
is really thick right there. Probably do the same thing I'm doing on this side here. For continuity, just lighten up some spots. I'm really liking this. That might be all I do to it today. Look at all these little spots. It looks like rained on or something. This section, but I gotta take it down.
You can only lift so many times before you start to degrade or erode the paper, so I don't want to do that. Sort of merge here, you don't know what is on what side. That. And then this Oh, my foot is asleep. Oh no. Oh my gosh, my leg is asleep. Oh, I'm pale. I need to go get some sun. But they closed the pool at my apartment complex, so I can't go lie out in the sun, even though it's really nice out. Stupid. Anyway. Can you hear the people racing on the freeway? People have been racing a lot more on the freeway because there's like less cars, so they can go really fast on the freeway. It's pretty funny. I know, I would be flying if I had a motorcycle. Just go so fast. And if you see up close, it has, like, I put some of the red in to the shadowy part, so it's not just green here. There's some of the red on this side. And let's see about, what does it look like on camera? I don't know what that spot is. I didn't just do it, but I'll fix it. Yeah, this looks pretty good. Sometimes I look at things on camera to see what I would work on next, because you get like a different viewpoint. And the same for doing my makeup. Sometimes I will like, you know, do my makeup and then I come on camera and I'm like, oh, I need to do this and add that. Or I take like a selfie and then look at myself in the selfie and see what my makeup looks like, because I don't really know what it looks like. What did I do there?
like gouache paint. It can be tricky, but I think I've learned. Most of the troubleshooting. And then I'll probably buy a piece of, like, a wood panel they have that you can paint on, but instead of painting on it, I'll probably glue this on there. There's all kinds of, like, brush hairs that shed. They could kind of look like twigs. I'll leave them. Yeah, this will probably, I like this a lot, so. Yeah, all right, this one I think is done for tonight, then it'll dry and then I'll go over with the yellow tomorrow. Set it upright so Tuxie cannot lie upon it. What would my next move be here? I have my black canvases, and then I have the one that I had done originally, and I played with it with my fingers, and so you can see my fingerprints on it when you look at it, different angles, and that's pretty cool in itself. Oh no, there's like a dent. So I don't know what this would even be. It could be modern art, abstract expressionism, just go hang this on a wall like that. My moods, my painted black moods. Then I have two more here, and they're all small, so I could do like a series of something. And I'll put those away. And hi, you're gonna have to move, baby. I know, I don't like to disturb you all. Since I took my suitcases out, I have much more space. So I have quite a few canvases. I might have like 8 canvases to paint on. Oh, my timer. Oh, it smells so good. At first I was like, oh wait, I don't want it to burn, but I just got an incredible whiff. 7 minutes. Check it, like 1 minute. So last night I was working on this and I painted a new horizon line, but then it was too bright of a peach, so I just wiped most of it off. And hi, you're chunky. I love
She's so tolerant. So tolerant of my love. She was really needy today, like every 2 seconds. Meow, pet me, pet me. I was editing some of my photographs for another portfolio I have. She was not having it. She pay attention to me right now. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I love your whiskers. They're so cute. And I could find the photograph and continue to work on it. I mean, it doesn't need too much more work. There are some strings I noticed in the photograph that go from like here down straight through the middle of my beautiful clouds. So I'm going to have to like measure it and get the right brush. I don't have the right brush for it. And I could probably draw it in pencil with a ruler first and then super duper fine brush. I mean, I do have this brush, but even that might be too big. They sell smaller ones anyway. I could go get one when they open the stores. I need my art supply stores to be open. And my oil paint should still be wet from last night. I'm gonna see if I can make this a little bit whiter. Like, I like blue and white, like real crisp blue and white together. I just really love that. So I want to accentuate that. Where is my box of oil paint? Is it in the closet where it should be? Oh. Yep. I love my life. It's amazing. And I tried to fix a chip up here. It's not as noticeable, but I don't like that. Oh yeah, this should be like much brighter of a white than it is. And the sails too. No, you can't see like how there's the white part of the sails like here and here. It's pretty white. And then the creases are not dark enough. Okay, so this shouldn't take too long to do. My hands are so dry. I washed them so much. Oh wait, there it is. Okay. And my small brushes are here. White. I miss being live. I miss my buddies interacting while I do this, but it's fun to be in silence.
Go in. You see her paw under the door. Oh. Okay, look at this before it overcooks. I don't want it to be dry. Oh, it smells so good. Oh my gosh. Yes. Ooh. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. Like, it's not too sweet of a smell, it's more like a, I don't know. Oh! Alright, I have to test it though, because just because it's golden doesn't mean it's cooked. And I don't have toothpicks, so I have to use a knife to test. And the way you do that is you just take a knife, you stick it in the middle. I don't know about that. Try another one. All right, 5 more minutes. This better work. Should probably have read the reviews before I just went and baked something. I didn't do that. I picked a 5-star recipe, but she's in the closet. What are you doing?
she brings me joy
to my life. Oh, where was I? I hear you purring in there. Yeah. Do you like being in the closet? Use some of the excess. Oh, you can't even see what I'm doing. Okay. Just brush on the sails here. Oh, no, I don't like that. Check this again, and if it's still gooey, then that's probably just banana that I'm sticking it in. But still, I don't know if it's cooked. Oh, eyelashes stuck together. It's probably just banana, so I'm just gonna let that cool like that. Probably sprinkle some powdered sugar on there in a little while. And that's my cooking for today, being all chunky fat on Triscuits. That line is really crooked. much brighter, I think. Oh, I'm actually tired. No, it's a trick. It's a trick because I know I stayed up one night and I was adding my photos to my portfolio album. And then I was like, oh, I'm tired now. I can go to sleep. No. Nope. My brain was active for another hour or so. It was all a lie. And then, I don't know, I just lie there with my eyes open, trying to look at the universe, I don't know. Is that what insomnia is? I don't think I have insomnia. I just like going to sleep when the birds start chirping and it starts getting nice and sunny out. So anything before that is kind of iffy. I'm trying to get this part of the water right here to match this part a little bit. It doesn't have to match exactly. This part would be more shallow because it's more inland. This is more out. And then I noticed there's some little waves in the background there. I wonder if I could paint them in. Yeah, why not? Flip it around to get the other angle. Yes, that looks great. One more tiny one. I think I like it. I think I'm happy with it. One more thing right here.
Alright, now I think it's done.
Where would I sign my name to it if I were to do such a thing? In the bush? In the water?
Oh, the AJ. That's good enough, right?
Okay, cool. Yeah. Wish I would have just left that side alone.
Cool, I've been on here 1 hour and 49 minutes. That doesn't feel like long.
What should I work on now?
I don't feel like working on anything else anymore. Just this evening.
Alright, cool. And I'll show you my final results.
Ta-da. It looks so much better in daylight. I'll probably come on and make a video of this one and another one in the daylight, because the blue, it's not even, it doesn't look anything like this in daylight. It's like brighter and like a lot happier. And see, there are not clouds in this photo, but in my painting I just decided to make it have some, so I don't always go for exact copies. I just kind of go for close enough. It's really dark over there. Huh. All right, cool. Cool. I'll wipe this off. And thank you for watching. And watching all my other videos. And if you like this video, please click like and subscribe for more awesome content. And fun stuff. Okay, good night.